And so they're finally brought before a great white throne judgment. A great white throne judgment that has on the throne guess the one sitting and judging all of his creation. Guess who he is? His name is Jesus. He's the judge of all mankind, and everyone will be brought before him. All my friend, the old and the young, the rich and the poor, red, yellow, black and white. It makes no difference who you are, where you were born, and when you were born. You're brought before that great white throne judgment to be judged for your sins. I can spare you that. I can stop that from happening. I can put a roadblock in the way of that. How do you do it, preacher? What can keep me out of the great white throne? It's the Lamb of God that went to the tree, that died on the cross. You can't see him, but you can feel him. You can't touch him, but you can hear him. You can't bring him into your house and look at him like you would me. But he's more real than I am. He can go where I can't go. He can do what I can't do. He's the Lamb of God that taketh away the sin of the world. Let him take your sin away now, and you'll rejoice with him for eternity. Let him carry it as he did the cross outside Jerusalem. Let him bear it out of your soul. Empty that deep down inside you where you're crying for help now. You've tried self-help. You've tried self-love. You've tried religion. You've tried education. You've tried achievement. You've tried your job. You've tried people. You've tried counseling. You've tried it all, and it all fails you. But you've never really tried Jesus. If you ever really take him, if you really, really receive him into your heart, you'll be changed that moment. You'll never be the same. You'll rejoice forever. You'll say, lost without God I was, but now I'm saved. I once was blind, but now I see. That's all about him, friend. He's coming soon. He's coming to the earth, and he's going to shout the names of the sons of God. And I'm one of them. I'm listening for my name. When he says that shout, it'll just be one shout. One shout, just one shout. One shout from the Son of God. But it'll have every name in it of every born-again believer that ever has lived. And somewhere in there I'll hear, Charles Lawson. Charles Lawson. Hey, Charles Lawson. Yeah, come up hither. Up we go to meet him in the clouds. Who's that going before me? Who are these people? Well, they look like they lived in the last 200 or 300 years. There's one coming up who looks like he lived 1,000 years ago. He's ahead of me. How'd you get in front of me? But we're all going to the same place. The dead in Christ shall rise first. I've carried many of them out there. They're coming up first. That body's coming out of the grave. You're crazy, preacher. Don't bother me, friend. I'm happy. I got something in my soul. I'm almost 64 years old. I got more life in me, more joy in me, more reason to live than most of you that are 20. The only thing you know is what you can pack with your hand, you can talk to on the phone, or you can look, stare at in some TV. You don't even know how to live. I got a life breathing in me. It's boiling in me. It's rising. Yeah, it is. I got life in my soul that rises high. It reaches to glory, takes hold of God, and says, I love you. I know you, and I know you're coming again. Is it coming for you? Amen. Father, in Jesus' name, bless your word, and bless the preaching of your word. In thy holy name I pray. Amen. This youngest generation, it's so lost that if you took their iPods and iPhones and computers and all their gadgets away from them, they would be lost. They'd look outside at a big world and they'd think, now what am I going to do now? What can I do out there? Walk down next to the creek. Sit down next to the bank. Look down at the crawdads as they swim in that water. Go down to the river. Sit out on a bluff as the rock juts out over the river and watch the fish swim by. Drive up to the mountains and watch the fog as it goes down into the valleys and rises across the mountain and feel the breeze as it hits you in the face. Rise up and realize that even though this earth is cursed, that Almighty God still has beauty left here. Amen. Imagine what it looked like before sin blighted it, when he made it in the original pristine form that it was. The Bible said he saw the earth and it was good. Walk outside and get out of your house and walk out into what God's made. You'll find out there's a life out there that can be lived. But get on your knees and cry out to him. Ask him to come into your heart. You'll find a life that's higher than anything on this earth. Eternal life, salvation. You'll know the Lord Jesus Christ. Then when you breathe his air, look at his flowers, and listen to his birds sing, and enjoy his creation. All the time, instead of worshiping the creature, you'll worship the Creator, who is God blessed forevermore. I breathe his air. I walk on his earth. I live in this place. But I know who made it, and I know who sustains it. And this morning I give him glory, and I give him praise. Some of you will be brought to the point where you'll make a decision. Will you take the mark or will you reject it? You're younger than I am. If Jesus doesn't come back soon, I believe he will. But if he doesn't, I may go the way of all the earth. That's okay. I know where I'm going. I know whom I have believed. But some of you younger people right here, you may very well be faced with taking a mark. It's called the mark of the beast. The name, the number of his name, or his name. Any one of these three things you could be forced to take. And listen to me carefully. Listen, the way the government's headed now, becoming a totalitarian government. It's a big brother government. It's a government, my friend, that nobody 20, 30 years ago ever thought it'd be like it is now. They want more surveillance, more surveillance, more surveillance. They want to watch everything you do, read everything you write, listen to everything you say. That's where the government is right now. Why would they want that kind of control? The reason they want it is because the man of sin shows up. He'll use that kind of control. Because you won't be able to buy or sell unless you have the mark of the beast, the number of his name, or his name. If you don't have that, you won't even be able to live on this earth. You say, I'll run off in the woods. They'll follow you. They can track you. They have technology now where they can fly over a field, over woods with a helicopter, and see any creature in it that has warm blood flowing through its veins. They can hear you. They've got technology now that hears things that the human ear can't even hear. They can see and hear you. They can track you. That means that the Antichrist has set up the system. He's got everything ready to step in the stage of time and take control. Are you ready?